This is Times Drive and I'm Joel Pereira, and yeah, I'm in a tank because today we're at the Armoured Corps Center and School in Ahmednagar spending some quality time with the real bad boys of the battlefield. Say hello to my little friend.
Ever since the first tank rumbled over the trenches in the Battle of Somme in World War I, the tank has always been the clenched iron fist of any field army. Completely mobile, capable of running over most obstacles that come in its way, and with its awesome firepower coming from a massive main gun on a swiveling turret, the battle tank is an instrument of destruction. And if you're facing one in a combat situation, an instrument of fear.
This sheer power, you know, when a tank starts, it doesn't start, it roars. You know, it's like a lion walking in the jungle, and everybody sees it and everybody's afraid of it. So that's how you feel. You feel bold.
With the main guns being able to reach out and inflict tremendous damage in distances measured in kilometers, when you see a tank on the battlefield, you need to run or hide.
There's nothing they can do to stop a beast like this.
Or you were able to get into battle at a faster pace, in a place of your own choosing, create a lot of surprise, and thereby the surprise and the flexibility added to the shock effect of the enemy.
So to come face to face with India's battle tank arsenal, we had to come to Ahmednagar, to the home of the Indian Armoured Corps.
India has a long history of armoured warfare, beginning since before independence. But independent India's first armoured divisions first saw service in 1947. Tanks have played a major role in the defence of the nation ever since, and currently, the Indian Army has three main tanks in deployment: the T-72, the T-90, and the indigenously produced Arjun main battle tank. Which brings us to the T-72, one of the mainstays of Indian armor, and personally my favorite looking tank. This is mean, low slung, and just full of brutish menace. I love it.
It's a Russian tank. It was manufactured first by Russia in 1970, and towards the end of the 1970s it was inducted into the Indian Armored Corps, and now we are manufacturing this tank in our country. This tank has a crew of three: the driver, the gunner, and the commander.
Called the Ajaya by the army, the T-72 has been the armor-plated backbone of Indian armor for more than two decades. This is a tank that is rugged, has a sleek silhouette and low weight that we think makes this tank look more like a sports car than combat vehicle. And then there's the tremendous firepower. 125mm main gun, the 12.7 anti-aircraft machine gun, and the anti-personnel coaxial machine gun mounted right next to the main gun.
It has a 125mm smoothbore main gun, which is capable of firing ammunition in a direct roll up to 4 kilometers, and when employed in an indirect roll, it fires up to 9600 meters. This tank is armor protected from all over. It is immune to small arms and splinter fire, which makes it practically impenetrable by any ammunition.
With huge size comes huge power. The Ajaya comes with a massive engine mounted towards the relatively safe rear portion of the tank. The T-72's got a V-12 that's putting out close to 840 bhp.
It has a supercharged multi-fuel engine which is capable of running on petrol, diesel and K2. And the power to mass ratio of this tank gives it the agility and the maneuverability it needs in today's battlefield. If you're in a desert, this can go up to almost 45-50 kilometers. However, the maximum which it can touch on a flat road is about 65 to 70 kilometers. For the size and the magnitude of this machine, it just sails over any kind of ground. I mean, if you go over broken ground, you won't feel as if you're going into a mud pod or something.
Extreme mobility is the hallmark of the tank, and getting to battle with speed and decisiveness is the hallmark of Indian armor.
In a time frame where you could not visualize, you could get behind the enemy without the enemy really coming to know, notwithstanding the fact that a lot of noise and dust does get generated, but then that adds to the surprise factor.
And it began back in 1947 itself, during the Indian Army operations in Kashmir at the Battle of Zoji La. M5 Stuart tanks were dismantled and flown up to more than 11,000 feet above sea level, an altitude where it was previously thought that tanks could not be operated.
When Kashmir was under threat, tanks were dismantled and airlifted into place, and it actually clinched the battle, because they appeared at a point where the enemy least expected.
Now, another part of the triumvirate of Indian armor is the T-90 tank. Now, this is a tank of Russian origin and considered to be the worthy successor to the T-72. It's bristling with technology and firepower, and really look at it. Is there any way you think you're going to run away from that 125mm cannon?
Like the T-72 has a three-man crew, the driver, the gunner and the commander. It's again a medium weight tank and weighs about 46.5 tons. This is one of the latest tanks in the world. It's the latest version of the T-series. It was inducted into the Armoured Corps in 2001.
Called the Bhishma by the tank men who drive them, introduced by the Indian Army in the early part of the last decade, the T-90 is a terror of the battlefield, moving with tremendous speed towards any enemy.
This tank again is extremely agile and maneuverable, can go over trenches and small nalas, can negotiate a gradient of up to 30 degrees.
This is a state-of-the-art weapons platform with thermal imaging, composite armor and a massive 125mm smoothbore tank gun, a 12.7mm anti-aircraft gun and a coaxial 7.62 anti-personnel machine gun.
Now this is the anti-aircraft 12.7mm machine gun which can be operated by the commander while he is sitting inside the cupola. It is highly effective against helicopters and can engage them at a range of about 1500 meters, and this gun is extremely handy during while we are fighting in built-up areas. The commander can be cupola down, sitting in his fighting compartment, and can engage the enemy while he's inside.
Again, for a tank this huge, you're going to need a massive engine behind it. And that's what the T-90 has, an approximately 1000 bhp 12-cylinder engine that's flex fuel, using either petrol, diesel or even kerosene.
It's got the firepower you've seen for yourself. The 125mm gun gives you a range of about 2000 meters of pinpoint accuracy. you know, the varied terrain that we have, right, in our country. I mean, it ranges from jungles to high mountains to deserts. Combat vehicles like tanks, infantry combat vehicles like the BMP, today are employed in all these types.
For the size and the magnitude of this machine, it just sails over any kind of ground. I mean, if you go over a broken ground, you won't feel as if you're going into a mud pot or something.
Extreme mobility is the hallmark of the tank, and getting to battle with speed and decisiveness is the hallmark of Indian armor.
In a time frame where you could not visualize, you could get behind the enemy without the enemy really coming to know. Notwithstanding the fact that a lot of noise and dust does get generated, but then that adds to the surprise factor.
And it began back in 1947 itself, during the Indian Army operations in Kashmir at the Battle of Zoji La. M5 Stuart tanks were dismantled and flown up to more than 11,000 feet above sea level, an altitude where it was previously thought that tanks could not be operated.
When Kashmir was under threat, tanks were dismantled and airlifted into place, and it actually clinched the battle, because they appeared at a point where the enemy least expected.
Now, another part of the triumvirate of Indian armor is the T-90 tank. Now, this is a tank of Russian origin and considered to be the worthy successor to the T-72. It's bristling with technology and firepower, and really, look at it. Is there any way you think you're going to run away from that 125mm cannon?
Like the T-72 has a three-man crew, the driver, the gunner and the commander. It's again a medium weight tank and weighs about 46.5 tons. This is one of the latest tanks in the world. It's the latest version of the T-series. It was inducted into the Armoured Corps in 2001.
Called the Bhishma by the tank men who drive them, introduced by the Indian Army in the early part of the last decade, the T-90 is a terror of the battlefield, moving with tremendous speed towards any enemy.
This tank again is, it's like a lion walking in the jungle, and everybody sees it and everybody is afraid of it. So that's how you feel. You feel bold.
With the main guns being able to reach out and inflict tremendous damage in distances measured in kilometers, when you see a tank on the battlefield, you need to run or hide.
There's nothing they can do to stop a beast like this.
Or you were able to get into battle at a faster pace, in a place of your own choosing, create a lot of surprise, and thereby the surprise add the flexibility added to the shock effect of the enemy.
So to come face to face with India's battle tank arsenal, we had to come to Ahmednagar, to the home of the Indian Armoured Corps. India has a long history of armoured warfare, beginning since before independence. But independent India's first armoured divisions first saw service in 1947. Tanks have played a major role in the defense of the nation ever since, and currently the Indian Army has three main tanks in deployment: the T-72, the T-90 and the indigenously produced Arjun main battle tank. We'll be right back.
Which brings us to the T-72, one of the mainstays of Indian armor. And personally, my favorite looking tank. This is mean, low slung, and just full of brutish menace. I love it.
It's a Russian tank. It was manufactured first by Russia in 1970. And towards the end of the 1970s, it was inducted into the Indian Armoured Corps. And now we are manufacturing this tank in our country. This tank has a crew of three: the driver, the gunner, and the commander.
Called the Ajaya by the army, the T-72 has been the armor-plated backbone of Indian armor for more than two decades. This is a tank that is rugged, has a sleek silhouette and low weight that we think makes this tank look more like a sports car than combat vehicle. And then there's the tremendous firepower. 125mm main gun, the 12.7 anti-aircraft machine gun and the anti-personnel coaxial machine gun mounted right next to the main gun.
It has a 125mm smoothbore.
So to come face to face with India's battle tank arsenal, we had to come to Ahmednagar, to the home of the Indian Armoured Corps.
India has a long history of armoured warfare, beginning since before independence. But independent India's first armoured divisions first saw service in 1947. Tanks have played a major role in the defense of the nation ever since, and currently the Indian Army has three main tanks in deployment: the T-72, the T-90, and the indigenously produced Arjun main battle tank.
Which brings us to the T-72, one of the mainstays of Indian armor. And personally, my favorite looking tank. This is mean, low slung, and just full of brutish menace. I love it.
It's a Russian tank. It was manufactured first by Russia in 1970. And towards the end of the 1970s, it was inducted into the Indian Armored Corps. And now we are manufacturing this tank in our country. This tank has a crew of three: the driver, the gunner, and the commander.
Called the Ajaya by the army, the T-72 has been the armor-plated backbone of Indian armor for more than two decades. This is a tank that is rugged, has a sleek silhouette and low weight that we think makes this tank look more like a sports car than combat vehicle. And then there's the tremendous firepower. 125mm main gun, the 12.7 anti-aircraft machine gun and the anti-personnel coaxial machine gun mounted right next to the main gun.
It has a 125mm smoothbore main gun, which is capable of firing ammunition in a direct roll up to 4 kilometers, and when employed in an indirect roll, it fires up to 9600 meters. This tank is armor protected from all over. It is immune to small arms and splinter fire, which makes it practically impenetrable by any ammunition.
With huge size comes huge power. The Ajaya comes with a massive engine mounted towards the relatively safe rear portion of the tank.